will present the activities of the working group 6 dissemination. I used the same presentation that I did in Dublin about 1 year ago, maybe more, to show you the improvement with respect to that dental workshop, which was in the spring of last year. Many of the things we were planning to do have been done, some are still in progress, work in progress. But as Sebastian showed this morning, this last month of the actions will be devoted to dissemination. So we plan to do the final things in this period. So what is how we designed our dissemination activity in this action? Actually, trying to address these two questions. What we have to disseminate? Who are our targets? Who are our clients, let's say? And how? What is the best way to convey the message? So the response, the answer to the first question is mainly that we have to disseminate two things. The outcomes of the construction, so the framework that we have been developing, and of course all the activities connected, for example the case studies or the scientific papers that have been prepared, but also the second aspect, which is focal for the constructions in general, which is the networking activity. Because the constructions are, first of all, networking projects, which are meant to create a network working on a scientific project. But the first aim is the creation of the network. So the outcomes of the project are both the content of the project itself, but also the networking activity. The second question is who are our targets? Mainly three groups of three categories of persons, which are researchers, industry, and general public. Of course, general public includes the three categories because all of us are general public, we are all general public, but some of us are industry, meaning that they have a more specific technical preparation, but that is that the group of researchers that has the knowledge, should have the knowledge at least, and should try to talk with industry and with general public, but of course, as I said, trying to convey the message so that they can understand. And the third question is how we convey this message to these three categories of three categories that make our public. Okay, let's start from the general public. These have been the, so what are these three rectangles? The first, the red one, is what we have been doing and what was already completed last year in Dublin. The website of the action, the trailer and the video of the action, which are of course very straightforward way to describe what we have been doing. Then at that time we were just starting with the social media, Facebook and LinkedIn, and in the last year we have been very, very active on this. And Maria Giovanna, after me, will describe more in details what we have been doing. And then we have recorded testimonials, some of you have done it today, but we have already several of them on the website. And these testimonials are very, very useful, because we have seen that usually these testimonials are put on the website, but also we use them for our posts on LinkedIn and Facebook. And when we put some videos, some testimonials, someone who is alive and talks, people go there and look at the post much more with respect to a starting one, to one who is just text, or just text and some images. So the idea of this testimonial, of course, is to explain what we are doing, but mainly to attract the attention toward this project we are working on. What was in progress in Dublin and still is, are two things. One is the Wikipedia page, which Sebastian is working on. And the other is the page for Dublin, which was mentioned by Michael this morning, which is a very difficult thing to do, because it's very difficult for all of us, and we realize it, asking for the post, it's very difficult to explain what we do to people that are not technical. We are not used to do this, and so we have been receiving the post for the Facebook and LinkedIn, which couldn't be published. Not because they were wrong, of course, they were very right, but they were not written in a language that could be understood by a general public. So we had to translate it. Not always we had the resources to do that, because it takes a huge amount of time. So you can imagine that the page for Dams, the page for Dams was the page of the web, where we were planning to explain what was the framework of the action, what was the meaning, and so on. It's still an idea, because actually I asked Michael to do that, but as he said, we will do it in the next 6 months. Okay, that was the general public. Then the industry, the second group. Second group includes industry, but industry are also professionals, owners, managers, people that are somehow technical, but are not researchers. What have we done for them? We prepared a PowerPoint and a poster of the action, which were meant to be used in meetings with national groups or also at conferences. The poster should have been used in offices, and both of them, both the PowerPoint and the poster, are in the website, in our website. So you plan to present the action at the general at the meeting with the people that belong to the industry, this is could be the best way to do it. Of course, they can also be used as a starting point to be modified, but there are all the information about the project written in a way that can be understood. Of course, at the time in Dublin, second rectangle, second box, we were planning to organize workshops and special sessions, and to support the Innovation Committee for the Industry Day, which both things have been done. The last box, the idea was to put the case studies on the website. Since the case studies are not completed, this has not been done yet, but we plan to do it. And what I would like is that this case studies, of course, they will not be put there as fact sheet, because they will not be effective in that way. We should find a format so that these case studies can be attractive for industry, that someone reads and says, okay, this is interesting, can be interesting for me, I can use it. And this means that we don't need a fact sheet for this aim. We need a format that we should try to imagine to invent. This is the easiest task, because these are the usual things we do: papers, special sessions, list of publications published on the website, training school have been done. Last thing, not been done yet, special issue on the value of information. I've heard that some special issues are being organized outside of this working group, so I'm happy about that. The The network, as I said, the content of the project is the project itself, but also the networking activities. We have to communicate who we are, where we are, meaning at which step of the project we are, and how we are connected. The way we choose to communicate all these concepts, all these ideas, was the trailer and the video. Both of them are on the website. Both of them have been used for posts on LinkedIn and Facebook, and they have been published. And we have put on the website a link how to join the action. Of course, now it's very late to join the action, but at that time was needed to attract and to explain people how can they join us. Then on the website as well, there is a map showing the location and the affiliation of all the participants so that we could show the extent of the network. Other things that have been done in the last year, we have put all the international connections we have on the website, put testimonials, and social media. Social media, LinkedIn and Facebook, we have tried to boost both of them with not always with a great success. Actually, we need to have more like and sharing, because we can put the post on the socials, but if this post stays in our group, it's not very effective. If all of us shares the post, it increases very much the number of people that see the post. So it is not that working on social media is not just putting the post there, posting the video or the text, is sharing. So we need a collaborative effort on this. We are still planning to put on the website an active participant page to thank people that really work in the action, and another page with the connection with other networks. And then another thing that we could do is open and maintain the page on ResearchGate that we still didn't have. Well, we have a page, but it's not very used. So who worked for dissemination? These are mainly the contribution that we had. The website, from a technical point of view, has been set up by Anne Ruske, and Simona Miraglia helped a lot on this. Maria Giovanna Masciotta will present Facebook and LinkedIn. She received some help from Francesco Giordano in the last year. Simona works as well on the list of publication, and the PowerPoint and the poster that I mentioned that can be used for presentation were prepared by Elder Suzanne and Luiso Santos. Now we will have a problem. Maybe a group of an order, because I'm looking for help. And I volunteer with some of you. Why? Because as I said, we need to still do some work for this action. As I said, I would like to see the case studies on the website when they are ready in a form which is effective for professionals. So I'm asking a volunteer, Jorge and Dominic, to prepare this. Using your case study, you can work together or each of you by himself. Try to sell your product to someone that you want to use this value for you.
One hint is we may use the classification and the right paper for the EFSA conference, maybe illustrate a classification, and it could be along the classification that we also put this in a website as an idea.
If it's effective for industry, yes. We have to think that, Brisa or someone else reads it, understands and wants to buy. This is,
Just a question.
Because
you said that you have
the points.
From the case, I'm considering
The recent template on the website for the fact sheet. There is a template for the fact sheet on the common what we call the documents of the
fact sheet.
Then second point, this is a difficult one because I don't even have an idea about who I can volunteer for that. We need articles for papers for journals like that, which are not scientific papers, but we need to talk about our action. For example, on the post web, you want to do that? Yeah, I'm looking for someone who writes this kind of paper. They don't have to be technical, but they have to be for a general public, but not for, explaining what we are doing and what is the utility of this.
Anyway, we will contact Anna as well.
Yeah.
Then support to Sebastian mainly means technical support, because you are, of course, you are writing, I guess, the Wikipedia page.
Yeah, well, the point here is that I don't have any experience in setting up a Wikipedia page.
So anybody if you
has anybody of you experience that?
Okay, so here I don't know how to proceed. Research aid, would you be available? We have research aid, there is a page due for Timo 2 because for by chance it was open, but it's not maintained. I'm not aware about the functionality of research game. So if you could go into okay, share on LinkedIn and Facebook. As I said, we can put the post, but without your help, without you sharing, you have to go on LinkedIn and Facebook and share the post. Because otherwise it has no impact. It has 10 times the impact. As many times as the people that share, in fact, if you share, because it goes on your page and all the your connections see the post. If it's just me putting the post that there are the two or three that like and not even share, we are looking for just to spend our time. Then, the last thing, as I said, the page for dummies. We are creating a task force to support Michael Faber. Elizabeth volunteered, but in this case she's a real volunteer, I didn't force her. Of course I could work on that. And maybe, Sebastian, since you were asking what support can give the action, here maybe a short-term certification to help to push Michael could be great. Not only to push Michael, Michael of course doesn't, I don't think she draws maybe a short-term scientific mission could be an idea to work on it, if possible. Let's think about that. So, if you have questions, yes.
As a volunteer, I would like to know what would you like in that point that you understand.
I want to sell the case studies. I want that people see the case studies and say, oh, this is a very interesting thing. I want to invest money in that.
So you want website design or?
Sorry?
You want website design or?
Yeah, I want a page for our website, a page where the case study is described in a way that captures the attention and shows that what is, why it's useful, why we are working on this, and why I should invest money on that. It's a difficult task, I know.
How is the website managed so far?
Is ending? No, but I don't want technical things.
Yeah, we don't necessarily need the website design, but the content.
I want the content for you. Don't worry about the technical aspect. We have someone who takes care of that. I want a page. You can even send me a word, but okay?
And to which reader should we write about case studies on public page? Because if we are doing case studies, if we want to publish something, how?
Again, writing
the theory. If we are going to write about case studies, to which reader? Because we can only say, what and why? We cannot say that will save you this amount of money because if you are working on case study and you want to publish it, then we cannot publish it on public page. You understand? We can say what are we doing, why it's good. It will save you money, but
some more in detail. I mean, if you just say
of course, more in detail. Yeah, of course.
You have to be
they send you because you are interested, you have interest in advisory role. So they send you the post and you say, okay, I will buy it, or I will
buy it. And you buy it.
And you buy it.
You
can be with
the voices.
Only with the advisory board is speaking and have a bottom line. Yeah, but at least Inger can be used as to get an advice because they are interested. So,
yep.
Okay. So I don't hear you as well. Okay. Other questions? Now I want you, I leave the floor to Maria Giovanna. I just want to let you understand and to laugh a little bit. I will show you something. So, just to show you what is the typical language of the post we receive. Of course, this is not a specific California, but just to let you understand. We usually receive something like that. Read it, try to understand what happened. Let me show you in one moment what actually the message was. Did you read it? Are you ready? And I'm not joking. This is really the language of the post-crisis. It's something extremely complicated. Yeah, it's me, and yeah, this is me crying. But really, when you see extremely complicated thing, then I spend 2 hours trying to understand, and then the meaning is very easy. And immediately, you are familiar with that?
No.
Okay, this is now.